Hey everybody, Unstable Gamer here, and welcome back to another Marvel Battle Lines video. So we had a new update come out, all about Captain Marvel. This came out a little while ago, and then we got some new cards that were injected into the game. And there's some pretty cool looking cards in there. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at the cards. We're going to open a couple packs, and then we're going to go ahead and jump into challenge mode. But first, before we get into that, if you're just now finding this channel and you want to stay up to date with this and other games, consider hitting that subscribe button so you don't miss out. All right, and welcome back. Let's go ahead and go over to the shop and take a look at this pack here. So it is the Captain Marvel pack. And so we've got five cards in here, which was pretty cool. So I just saw this movie yesterday, so the cat makes much more sense. I've never really dove too much into the Captain Marvel lore. It's really cool. So I don't know if the cat has always been there, but the cat makes much more sense now. So let's go ahead and run through the different cards. Look at the your chances of getting these cards. And then I'm going to go ahead and open three of these packs and see if we can get lucky. So first is Ronin. So when a character is knocked out, deal 280 damage to a distant enemy. Very cool. You do some additional damage. You can probably use that strategically. When you are placing this card down and considering your battle lines and stuff, it does allow for some additional strategizing there, which is pretty cool. Let's go ahead and look at his full thing. To the ends of the universe, I pursue the enemies of the Kree. Pretty cool. Related cards are, he's got foes here, and then here's an ally one that is overturned. Pretty cool artwork as usual. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at the next one. So this one I just got. I went ahead and threw it up on Twitter. The link to my Twitter is on my main channel page. I'll also put it in the description below. So this is the young Nick Fury. On every turn, add 220 attack to all distant allies. Let's go ahead and take a look at him here. Sometimes you got to do the wrong thing to get the right results. And his related cards, we've got Coulson here and then two unidentified cards. And then down here are foes. We've got Ultron and Thanos, which makes perfect sense. Take a look at the artwork there. Very cool. All right. Let's go ahead. Next. So here's the cat. What do they call it? A flurkin? A flurker? Something like that. Cute cat, though. Very dangerous. Looks like octopus coming out of his mouth. All right. On every turn, if there are enemies nearby, earn a cosmic fragment. So a card that is very helpful, especially when you're using like Iron Man, cards that help you gain additional cosmic fragments so you can get up to those four as quickly as possible is always good. So his name's Goose. Meow. All right. Related cards. So we've got, I'm going to assume obviously it's going to be Captain Marvel, just not which Captain Marvel, right? And then obviously Nick Fury. There's the cute cat. All right, let's go on to the next card. We've got a action card here. So targeted an enemy, deal 950 damage to target enemy, and then remove this, and then remove from this battle after use. Makes sense. Proton strike, 950 damage for one cosmic fragment. That's not bad. That's a lot of damage for one fragment. Very cool. All right, related cards. Obviously, it's going to have to be Captain Marvel. There we go. Very nice artwork. Who is this that she's punching? Huh. Very cool. All right, next. Captain Marvel herself. After summoning and after moving, increase attack of all nearby and allies and self by 50%. So three cosmic fragments, 680 attack and 970 hit points. Not bad. Life will knock you down. You just have to get back up. And that's kind of the theme of the Captain Marvel movie, which is pretty cool. All right, related cards. Actions, obviously, is going to be her action, and then allies. Probably the cat is going to be here. Nice illustration. All right, so those are the cards. Now, what are the chances of getting these cards? So, let's see. Provides five cards. Uncommon cards, at least. You get a rare epic card, one times one guaranteed. So we get at least one epic, or rare or epic. There you go. Uncommon 56%, rare 37%, and epic is a 6%. So let's see what we get. First one. Boom, we get a rare right off the bat. Let's see what we get. Absorbing Man, Nick Fury. Obviously, none of these are going to be it because they're all rare and epics. Let's see what we got. Ah, I get Mordo. I don't get her. All right. Do I have Mordo? I don't think I have Mordo. I think that's my first time getting him. Very cool. All right. Well, at least I have a card I don't currently have. Let's go again. Let's go. There we go. We got three rares and two uncommon. Could always use Captain America. Max him out. Two Captain Americas. Just 48 more. Who's this? All right. We got Gamora. Shuri. And then another Nick Fury. All right, let's go to my last one. What do we got? We got two rares. Storm and Eradicate. Daredevil. Nova Centurion. All right, who's this? Oh, hey, I got the new Ronin. Very cool. Did not have him. So when a character is knocked out, deal 280 damage to a distant enemy. And then, who do we have here? So, another one of him. So I could upgrade both him and Fury right off the bat. So I got some cards I didn't have, which was good. I think it was worth it. And then let's take a look at Captain Marvel, the leader. Because we currently do not have her. And I believe this is the first new leader that has been added to the game. Everything else has just been skins of existing leaders. Let's go ahead and just take a quick look at her really quick. And she's pretty easy to get. All you got to do is log into the game for 7 days at least, and you'll be able to unlock her leader card right here. So what she does here, so 400 additional leader XP, or I'm sorry, hit points, and then add 150 attack to all allies after a successful battle line attack. So that will come in handy if you're not doing a one-shot in the arena. There's a whole lot of one-shotting, so I don't necessarily think Captain Marvel will be an arena leader. But once we unlock her and we play around a little bit. And the arena, the meta and everything changes a little bit. But for the most part, everybody goes for a one-shot. So that would really, really not come in too handy. I think Iron Man really is probably the best. Let's go ahead and take a look at that meta really quick. See how she might go. I haven't played the arena this season yet. Let's look at the top 100. Yeah, see, so it's dominated by Iron Man. You got Iron Man, there's Wasp there, another Iron Man, and there's some Black Widows. So, I mean, if you take a look, Iron Man still really is the one that most people are using, and that's just because those extra cosmic fragments help a lot. And having that cat in the new Captain Marvel cards is pretty cool. That would work out. All right, I'm going to go ahead and modify an existing deck that I have with the new cards that we got, just to kind of see how they stack up in here. So let's see. For Arena, I'm going to go ahead and pull out Thor. Throw Ronin in there, and then we will throw out Malekith. I mean, I don't really think that they're necessary for Arena. And we just kind of want to check these new cards out anyway. All right, where is Nick Fury? Probably past him, huh? Yep, he's right there. Boom, he's a 2-cost as well. And then while we're here, let's go ahead and just upgrade them. Really quick. Card upgrade. So I'm going to go from 460 to 506 and 660 to 726. Not bad. And then we are going to deal 308 damage to the distant enemy. Boom. There we go. And then here, 220 attack to all distant, and we're gonna go from 220 to 242, And then you can see the increase in attack and hit points. Let's go ahead and upgrade that. Very nice. Now, this card here, so if it is on every turn, add 242 attack to all distant allies, you could really buff up Malekith pretty quick there. You know what? I'm gonna throw one of them back in here. Let's see. I'm gonna take out Shaolau there. Let's go ahead and throw him, Thor, back in. Let's see what that combination does. So let's go ahead and jump into challenge mode really quick. And the reason why I'm going into challenge is because there is a event to get 10 challenges completed, and I've only got 10 days left, so I better get them going on. All right, so I got the new cards here. This is the right deck. Let's go. All right, going against the Wasp. Handicap.
Here we go.
Now we start playing a little bit gimped.
I have an idea.
All right, so they got Gwen.
Where can I get more of those?
Okay.
All right, good. At least this time I got the fragment where I want it, so I can get to four quick.
Sometimes you have to improvise.
I have to make every move count.
All right. Let's go ahead and get rid of this guy for now.
What if? Here's another angle.
All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and throw Ronin down. So this is gonna damage to distant enemy, right? So I got a plan here. I'll throw Ronin down.
Give me those.
And then I'll take out once they do their battle. Well, no, they're probably gonna block me. The computer will typically block you before they complete their battle line, so that's fine. Let's see if a fragment goes down where I want it, and it does not. So I'm going to be short a couple fragments if I do that. Ah, you know what? I'm just going to do this. That way, they'll either block me or do their battle line. We'll see what happens. Yep, typically block.
Ready to rock.
Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of this guy here.
Set him up, knock him down.
That's pretty good. Look at that. So that was what again? When a character is knocked out, deal 308 damage to a distant enemy. So he did two attacks there. That was pretty cool. Let's go ahead and do this. Let's throw him over there. Now they're gonna block me again, which
better
is fine.
Make this one count.
Okay, time to dance. How about I lead?
Look at that, and then there's the buff. On every turn, boom. That's pretty cool, I like that. Let's see. I could throw Captain America down to get rid of both of those, but then I don't get to see the cool. That's all right. We're going to do that.
What a feeling. Give me those.
So I like that. That's pretty cool. And putting these two cards together, up, oh, Storm Summoning.
Am I forgetting something?
But Ronin stays in place. Very cool. Oh, but there we go with that.
Oh, I know what to do now.
Shall we?
Alright. But this is gonna be cool, so I'm gonna throw it down. Thor over there.
I'll take all I can get.
And unless she brings back that. That virus, I should be fine. Unless. Well, it forces them to use their action cards anyway.
Okay.
I need to get. That is so cool. I need to get. Nick Fury out here.
Maybe. Here's another angle.
There he is. Let's do that. That way he adds that attack.
More is better.
I have an idea.
I swear, Gwen is like one of the most annoying characters in here. Alright, boom. And then he gets buffed. Look at that. So does his buff, did that do a Yeah, that was cool. He freaking doesn't attack, plus he gets buffed. So it turns him in to a grower. Or turns anybody into a grower if you set him up right. That's pretty cool. I like that. I know I got some other cards like that, but this is pretty cool. 242 attack every turn. So I'm going to go for... I'm going to go for the one shot here.
Better make this one count. Don't mind if I do.
Here we go. Takes him out. And then we get up to 1400. That is so cool. That is awesome. I like that. And I'm just going to go ahead and throw Captain America in there. I like that combination of cards, those two cards in the deck. There we go. A little bit of lag there. And then here we go with all the damage.
It's gonna leave a mark.
Man. That is awesome. I'm gonna have to perfect this deck. So I'll keep my arena deck, but I'm going to perfect this deck because that was a lot of fun. All right, we're going to go ahead and go to the main menu now. All right, and then there's the deck that I just used. Essentially, it's my arena deck, but I pulled out Shao Lao and Malekith. So I kept Thor in there, but then I obviously put in Nick Fury and the new Nick Fury and the new Ronin, which I think worked out really well. So that was a lot of fun. So there you go, everybody. That's what I had for you today. Just wanted to do some pack openings and run through challenge a couple times and test out some new cards. And I think it was a lot of fun. So I hope you enjoyed the video. I appreciate you taking the time. Thank you for watching it. And if you enjoyed it, please make sure to hit that like button and share your thoughts and questions in the comment section below. Take care, everyone, and we'll talk to you next time.